Hi, welcome back. I am Sir Hendrik from Hendrik Academy. In this video, I will explain an important topic in mathematics, that is sketching a cubic graph. Before I begin this lesson, please click like and subscribe for this video. And afterwards, taking your pencil, ruler, notebook, and also your pen, and let's study with me till the end of this video. I will explain how to sketching this function's graph, y equal x cubed minus 6x squared minus x plus 30. The first step, you have to find the intercept points between this function and x-axis. To find the intercept on x-axis with an assumption y equals 0. If y equals 0, this y equals 0, it means these functions, it becomes x cubed minus 6x squared minus x plus 30 equals 0. If cube function, it means there are 3x. Okay, how to find the 3x, x1, x2, and x3? I'm going to using Horner method. But firstly, I will find which x is the root of these equations by trial and error of several factors of 30. I'm going to find which number it's 1. If a root of these equations, I will begin with x equal 1. If x equal 1, it means all x equal 1, and it becomes 1 cubed minus 6 times 1 squared minus 1 plus 30. Equal 34, 24. And secondly, I'm gonna check if x negative 1. If f negative 1, it becomes negative 1 cubed minus 6 times negative 1 squared minus 1 plus 30. Plus 1 here, okay. Also 24. If 24, 1 and negative 1 not include of roots of these equations, we have to find which number will make these equations equal 0. Okay. I'm going to check how about if x equal negative 2. If x equal negative 2, this equation is going to be negative 2 cubed minus 6 times negative 3, negative 2, negative 2 squared plus 2 plus 30. It becomes 8. It becomes 0. Yeah, because 32. So it means negative 2 is a root of this equation. Okay. Now I'm gonna apply Horner method to find 2x. The first x is negative 2. Next one, the coefficients of every variable, coefficients of x cubed is 1, coefficients of x squared is negative 6, coefficients of x equal negative 1, and constant number 30. Right, 1 plus 0 equal 1, and negative 2 times 1, negative 2, and it becomes negative 8, negative 2 times negative 8 plus 16, and negative 1 plus 16 plus 15, and 2 times 15 equals negative 30, and the remainder equals 0. All right. And I already checked another number is 3. Okay. So the first x equal negative 2 and the second x by trial and error, I already found 3. Now look, if 1 plus 0 equal 1, 3 times 1 equal 3, negative 8 plus 3 equal negative 5, and 3 times negative 5, negative 15, 5 plus 15, 15 minus 15 equals 0. So the first x, negative 2, second x, 3, and third x, you could find through this equation as x minus 5 plus 1 and negative 5. X minus 5 equals 0. It means x equal 5. So there are three coordinates point, negative 2, 0, 3, 0, and 5, 0. Right. Negative 2, 0 here, 3, 0 here, and 5, 0 here. Secondly, you're gonna find the intersect on y axis between these functions and y-axis. Just now we already find the intersect on x-axis, and those are 3, 0, negative 2, 0, and 5, 0. Intersect on y-axis we could find through an assumption that x equals 0. If x equals 0, these functions are gonna be y equals 0 cubed minus 6 times 0 squared minus 0 plus 30. Y equal 30. So the coordinate point 0, 30 here. Okay. Recall that we already found three coordinate point. Negative 2, 0, 3, 0, and 5, 0. So now we already have four coordinate points. Next step, we need to find the stationary values of this function. To find the stationary values, through an assumption that the first derivative equals 0. First derivative of this function is equal 3x squared. 3 times 1, 3. 3 minus 1 equals 2. Yeah, 3x squared minus 12x minus 1 equals 0. Now we are going to find roots of these equations. I'm going to apply to this formula x1 and x2 equal minus b square root d over 2 times a, which d equal b squared minus 4ac. So it means d equal, if it's one a, b, and c, it means it be d equal negative 12 squared minus 4 times 3. Plus 44 plus 12 equal 156. So x1 and x2 equal 12, because negative of negative 12 plus minus square root 156 over 6 because 2 times 3. It means x1 equal 12 plus square root of 156 is 12.5. After approximation of 6, and x2 equal 12 minus 12.5 over 6. Right, x1 equal 24.5 over 6, and it becomes 4.1, and x2 equal negative 0.5 over 6, and after approximation it becomes negative 0.1. Right, and this x positions 4.1 around here and negative 0.1 around here. I recall that we already have 4 coordinate points: negative 2, 0, 0, 30, 3, 0, and 5, 0. All right. Afterwards, we are going to find turning points. To find turning points, we need to using the stationary values x equal negative 0.1 and x equal 4.1. Yeah, negative 0.1 and 4.1. All right, and we already have 4 coordinate points. Negative 2,0, 0,30, 3,0, and 5,0. And this stationary point, stationary values position here and here, 4.1 and negative 0.1. Okay. If we submit this number, negative 0.1, into these equations, and y becomes negative 0.1 cubed minus 6 times negative 0.1 squared minus, it becomes 0 plus 0.1 plus 30. And if x equal 4.1, this functions becomes, this equation becomes y equal 4.1 cubed next 6 times 4.1 squared minus 4.1 plus 30. Okay, so through calculations, you're gonna find this coordinate point. Yeah, if x equal negative 0.1, through calculations, we could find y equal 30.04. And the coordinate point, negative 0.1, 30.04, negative 0.1 here and 30.04, 30 here, 0.4 around here. This is the turning point, the first turning point. Okay. Recall that we already have 4 coordinate points, 4 intercept points, negative 2,0. 0,30, 3,0, and 5,0. All Right. The second turning point, if x equal 4.1, y equal negative 6.04 through the calculation. And the coordinate point, 4.1, comma, negative 6.04. Negative 6, 4.1, comma, negative 6.04. Around here, 4.1 here, negative 6, this one, negative 6.04. This one. Okay. This is the position of the turning, the second turning point. Okay. Next, later on, we could connecting all coordinate point. All coordinate point we could connecting and will become a graph. Yeah, if you connecting this from this coordinate point, yeah, until this first turning point, going down until the second turning point, and go upwards. Okay, like that. And next, afterwards, we will find the gradient. Recall that the coordinate point R, the intercept point R, negative 2, 0, 0, 30, 3, 0 here, 5, 0 here, and the turning point, the first turning point, negative 0.1, comma 30.04 here, and the second turning point, the second turning point, 4.1 and negative 6.04, negative 6.04 here, around here, okay, the second turning point. All right, now we will find the gradient. Look at this, the stationary values. Okay, negative 0.1 and 4.1. We could check the gradient position, the gradient before this point, before negative 0.1. Yeah, after negative 0.1 and after 4.1. Okay. Before negative 0.1, the gradient, if we submit x into these equations, into this first derivative, the first derivative becomes 3 times negative 1 squared minus 12 times negative 1 minus 1. And it becomes 3 plus 12 minus 1 equal 14. 14, it means positive. If positive, the gradient increasing. Increase. So if x equal negative 0.1, first derivative will become 0. It means there is constant, no decrease and no increase. Just the turning point. So how about if x equal 2? It means first derivative becomes 3 times 2 squared minus 12 times 2 minus 1. And it becomes 12 minus 24 minus 1 equal 13. Equal 13. negative 13. I mean negative 13 here, and negative 13 here, it means decrease. Okay. If 4.1 equals 0, it means turning point. And then if 5, the first derivative becomes 3 times 5 squared minus 12 times 5 is 1. And it becomes 75 minus 60 minus 1 equals 14. Is increasing because positive. Okay. Now we're connecting this coordinate point and turning point. Look from negative 2, it increased because this gradient, okay, negative 1 increase, below of negative 0.1 increase. So it becomes like this. Around like this, yeah. And after that, from negative 0.1 into 4.1 become decreases, it becomes decrease, okay. Okay, until 4.1 here, and from 4.1 to the next interval, it becomes increase because the gradient increases like this. Okay. And this one, the gray graph, the real graph. And now we are going to find the maximum points and the minimum points. To find the maximum points, maximum turning points, and the minimum turning points, look, of course, this one, this turning point called as the maximum turning point, and this turning point called as the minimum turning point. Yeah. Okay, maximum turning point, this one, negative 0.1, comma 30.04, and this turning point 4.1, comma negative 6.04. This is the maximum turning point, negative 0.1, comma 30.04, and the second turning point, this one, is minimum turning point, 4.1, comma negative 6.04. All right, students, if you have any questions, maybe some of you not understand yet regarding this explanation, you could send me your message through this email, henrik.academy21@gmail.com. Thank you for your watching. Thank you for your lesson with me. See you.